The spread of this new illness basically wiped out demand for oil. Since people around the world are forced to stay at home and avoid unnecessary travel, few people are driving and flying. Crude demand in India, for example, plunged about 70% due to lockdowns. In the US, consumption is now the lowest registered in the last 30 years. European countries are affected as well. This video will cover how consumption has been affected in different countries, how the oil price war between Saudi Arabia and Russia made the situation worse, why the agreement between sides might not be enough, and how all of these affect industries and all of us. Make sure to watch the video till end, hit the like button, so YouTube shows it to other people as well, and make sure to subscribe to support the channel. So demand for oil is quite low worldwide. US oil demand has fallen to almost 14.5 million barrels a day, which is the lowest level since 1990, and it means a drop of more than 30% from pre-crisis levels. In India, the situation is even worse. According to Bloomberg, crude demand in the world's third biggest consumer has collapsed by as much as 70%, and consumption for the entire month could average about 50% below last year's levels. The world's biggest crude importer, China, may increase its processing rates to about last year's average levels. According to Bloomberg, Canada is the most affected country in the world, since it's estimated to have shut at least 325,000 barrels a day. In the UK, sales for diesel and gasoline are incredibly low, that is a drop by more than 55% for diesel and more than 65% for gasoline. In Italy, one of the hardest hit countries by the pandemic, due to lockdown, sales have fallen by about 85%. In Spain, gasoline consumption fell by more than 35% and diesel by more than 25%. If all of this wasn't enough, Saudi Arabia and Russia started an oil price war, which made the economic crisis even worse. The reason behind this price war is easy to understand. The two are big oil producers, and because of the fact that governments all around the world ordered lockdowns meant that these countries didn't need their oil. And now comes the interesting part. When you have huge supply of something without demand for it, the price of it will go down and vice versa. That means filling your tank becomes cheaper as well. The problem is that energy companies from other countries cannot keep up with this pace. You don't have to be a great economist to figure out that if you make a product with $100, you cannot sell it for $50, because you will lose. Some of these companies had to turn to loans in order to pay employees and stay afloat, but there's as much as banks can lend you, which ended up in some of them firing employees or going bankrupt. This, however, triggers a chain reaction. Other energy companies might also fail, which means more unemployed and further losses for suppliers which sell products to these companies. Alternative energy companies might seriously suffer as well, since low prices at gas stations mean that people won't really care for their alternative energy offers. Against all of these backdrops, Saudi Arabia, Russia and other oil-producing countries have agreed to cut about 10% of global production on April 12. The 9.7 million barrel a day production cut is the biggest such deal in history. That, simply put, means cutting supply to raise prices. That also means a bit more expensive gasoline or diesel at gas stations. It might not be the thing drivers really want, but the ramifications are far too great to only think about the final consumer, that is the average citizen. The deal, however, might not be enough. Experts estimate that demand has fallen by somewhere between 25 million barrels and 35 million barrels a day, which is up to 3.5 times as much as what the oil producers agreed to cut. Though the US government welcomed the deal, stating that it probably saved millions of jobs, experts warn that most companies will still have financial difficulties. Many companies cannot even dream of taking out profits at current prices, and the most affected places will probably be North Dakota, Oklahoma, Texas, and Alaska. The low demand is forcing companies to lay off thousands of workers. Lower prices will still remain after the deal, even at gas stations, which could somewhat raise demand, but until this health crisis is brought under control, the oil price war will still have its collateral victims. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time, but until then, don't forget to subscribe.